Hi everyone, welcome to Cyber Guidance. And today I will be demonstrating a real life cybersecurity incident. This actually happened to one of my clients, and I thought it's nice to create an awareness about this. Everything you're going to watch today is based on a real life scenario, and make sure you watch this video to the end. So this is what happened. A few days ago, my client received this email that looked a little bit legitimate. As you can see, it says, "We have detected a potential security issue with your Microsoft account that requires immediate attention." To cut the story short, she clicked on this link, and that was where the problem began. So before we start investigating, it is always important to understand what you want to investigate, and which is why I would also walk you through the steps on how I simulated this incident, because these are also the incident that occurred on my client's system. And you have to be extremely careful, because while I simulated this incident, if you look at the time, not up to 10 or 15 minutes later, I got a suspicious authentication activity on my device. I investigated this IP address. As you can see, the person tried to authenticate, probably using a brute force attack. He tried several usernames, and I found that this person is from Ukraine. You have to be extremely careful and make sure you're doing it on a sandbox. As you can see, under this name, Dimitro or Mitro. I also went further on to, you know, just check who this person is. And as you can see here, this IP address has been reported several times for fraud risk and for a lot of different things. So it just shows how powerful these exploits are and how they can open your devices to more vulnerabilities. So just to show a walkthrough of what the threat actor did on my client's device. So what the threat actor did was that he created a Metasploit post-exploitation tool. And what that does is that it makes your device vulnerable. And they could also go further. As soon as they get access into the device, they can use this ransomware script to encrypt your device and request for some money. Or they could just exfiltrate data or try to move laterally within the device. So we can do a walkthrough together to see how this works. And just make sure everything you're doing it in a safe environment. So we can copy these. Yeah, if you know your IP address, you can always put in your IP address. And you can also change this from payload to anything. You can use Microsoft services. It doesn't matter. And this also goes under detection on a lot of endpoint detection system or antivirus. However, not for Microsoft Defender though, and which is why sometimes I feel like Microsoft Defender is one of the best endpoint tools out there. So you can just use your IP, put in your IP address. And as you can see, it saved the payload already. What the threat actor did after that was that he uploaded this payload on a Google Drive and then generate a link from that Google Drive. And that they mostly do that to bypass email detection, so it can like get into the main inbox of the email. And yeah, you can also find this. I think if you click on home, yep, you can find the payload here, and then you can just open a Google Drive, or you can use a normal legit website, and then you can upload it on the Google Drive, generate a link from that, and then send it. After my client clicked on the link, the threat actor gained access into the device and was monitoring our activity. We immediately got an alert on one of our CM tools, which is Microsoft Defender. Without wasting much time, we delegated the task between each other, between my colleagues, and one of my colleagues called the client to gain more information. And this is done to speed up the investigation process and to get more information about what we have to investigate. The client indeed confirmed that she clicked the link and then she also downloaded some documents. That already gave me an insight because here I can see we've got two URLs and this is the Google Drive where the malicious payloads are being stored. So immediately she clicked on this link, the payload started running and the documents downloaded. Here you can see two files. You can see some files here. We took our time to investigate each of these incidents and also each of those files. We let the client know that we would be disconnecting our device from the network, which is isolating our device. Therefore, the threat actor cannot move laterally into other device or within the network. This is the device. Here, you can just isolate the device. As you can see, this has been isolated already. After carefully reviewing this document, our endpoint already quarantined and removed these files from the system. We then went further by creating a live session on this device, doing a deep forensic analysis and checking to see if any of those files are still in the location of or are in the file part of the device. We also disconnected the Metasploit connection, run a full antivirus scan. We changed the password and make sure everything was clean again. So as you can see here, you can just run a full antivirus scan and identify all the processes that are being connected with the Metasploit session. This we can also do on a live response, or we did a remote control on the device. Right now, the device is turned off. If not, I would have done some command line just to show the process of disconnecting a Metasploit session. And yeah, after that, we just made some documentation. We educated the client. We did some system updates, system patches, updated all vulnerabilities. And make sure everything was all good. And the client can also use the device again. So please make sure you like this video, share, comment. I would really appreciate that. Thank you.